Google introduced a rich snippet for pros and cons, and if you are using RankMath, we have incorporated this into our predefined schema markup, such as the book, course, event, movie, product, recipe, and software. So stay with me and let's explore this pros and cons structured data on RankMath so you can get something like this for your search results. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, and today we are going to explore something awesome. You know, right? We are talking about the pros and cons structured data, and yes, this is for pro users only. So if you are using the free version of RankMath, do consider upgrading to the pro version. We have covered so many things you can do with the pro version on this channel. Anyway, whenever you review a product, software, or whatever as a third party, it is common to add a list of pros and cons to your review article. I'm not sure if you have noticed, but even before the introduction of the structured data, Google would display something like this on some search results. So even if you don't add the pros and cons schema or markup, you may still get the rich snippets as Google will try to identify the pros and cons listed on the web page. But with the pros and cons structured data, you will tell Google that you have a list of pros and cons, which means a higher chance of getting the rich snippet. But do note that this new structured data is meant for editorial product review pages, in other words, third-party review articles. It is not meant for merchant product pages or customer product reviews. So to use the pros and cons structured data, the prerequisite is to have the schema structured data module turned on. If you don't see this module, you need to select the advanced mode. Next, let's add a new post. Say I'm writing a review about RankMath. I'll save this article as draft, and I'll go to the schema tab. Click on schema generator, and since RankMath is a software, I'll use the predefined software markup. I'll fill in all the necessary information about RankMath. And right after the review rating schema, we have the pros and cons. One thing to note here is for the pros and cons schema to work, we'll need to have at least two statements. It can be one pro and one con, or two pros without any cons, or vice versa. As long as there are two statements in the schema, it will work. Let's start with the pros. Make sure that each item is written on a new line, and we will add the cons. Now you may ask, what if you don't need the review rating schema? Let's say that I remove this rating. The question is the pros and cons schema still valid? The answer is yes, but let's find out. Let's save for this post, save this article as draft, and let's verify the schema data by clicking on this eye icon. Test with Google. And here we go. These two are optional schema data, in which we don't have the information because it's not applicable to our article. But what's important is the positive notes and the negative notes. So basically, the pros and cons schema is independent and it doesn't rely on the review rating schema. So on the positive notes, you will see the pro information with its respective position. So make sure to add the important items first. The same goes for the negative notes or the cons. So if you have review articles on your website and you are using one of these predefined schema markups, let's add those pros and cons information as schema markups so that your search results will be more visible. A quick way to display the pros and cons together with other schema information is to add the shortcode to the content if you are working on a page builder. Otherwise, if you are using the default WordPress blog editor, you can add the schema block by RankMath. And it will fetch the same result. Do make sure that you have a consistent list of pros and cons on your review article. Don't confuse Google and your site visitors. For example, do not add many useful functions in the pro schema data and have a few good useful functions on a page. The language and its meaning needs to be consistent. In this case, Google will prioritize the structured data you have supplied to them. In another sense, you may have a detailed version for your pros and cons on the page and have a short and concise version in the schema markup. There is a size constraint and not all pros and cons information will be displayed. So use this schema information wisely. Anyway, we hope this pros and cons schema markup is useful to you. We are always on our toes to give you the fastest and the most updated SEO tools. Hope you can smash that thumbs up button and do subscribe to our channel as we share a lot of useful SEO and business knowledge to help you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.